Hello, Gnana students. Welcome to the social science class. That is the second chapter, Geographical Features of our India. Geographically, environment has influenced every country and people in the world. There is an intimate relationship between human life and the environment. Hence, it is necessary you all should learn about the geographical environment in order to know about human history. Okay, children. Now let us move to the briefly about this chapter. India is called as a subcontinent because diverse physical features. It is a complete geographical unit with high mountain ranges, hills, plains, coast plains, beaches and islands. As India, it is surrounded by water on three sides and land on one side. So we will call it as a peninsula. India shares its boundaries with Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh and Myanmar. So, India consists of now 28 states and 9 union territories and one national capital region, that is Delhi. The various landforms enable us to divide India into 5 distinct physiographic divisions, each with its own characteristics. They are, first one is the Himalayan mountain. You can observe in the picture, children. Okay, stretch for a distance of 2400 kilometers. Geographically, Himalaya is divided into Trans-Himalaya, the Great Himalayas, the Himachal or Lesser Himalayas, then the Shivaliks, and last one is the Purvanchal Hills. The Trans-Himalayas, which are north to the Great Himalayan Range, are called as the Tibetan Himalayas also. And second one is the Great Himalayas. The range lying to the south of Trans-Himalayas is the northernmost of all the Himalayan ranges and most continuous mountain range of the world. And next one is the Lesser Himalaya, or running almost parallel to the Great Himalayas in the north and the Shivaliks in the south. Next one is the Shivalik. This Shivaliks comprises the outermost range of the Himalayas. And next one is the last one, the Purvanchal Hills. These are called as Eastern Hills also because they are located in the eastern part of India and run in the shape of a crescent. Now let us learn the second point, the Great Northern Plains. They are formed due to depositional work of three major river systems. They are the Indus, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra. The plains account for 2400 km of length and width ranges between 150 to 300 km. Now let us move to third point, that is the peninsular plateau. The plateau of India is roughly triangular in shape. The boundaries of plateau are surrounded by hill ranges on all the three sides. Then fourth point is the coastal plains. The coastline of India running for a distance of about 6000 kilometers from Run of Kunch in the west to the Ganga Brahmaputra Delta in the east is called coastal plains. The two coastal plains meet each other at the southern tip in Kanyakumari. Now next one is the islands. The Indian territory includes a large number of islands, among which the Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Lakshadweep Islands are the major island groups. Andaman and Nicobar Islands are located in the Bay of Bengal. It includes 265 big and small islands. Now the Lakshadweep Islands are located in the Arabian Sea and also are a group of 25 islands. Now the last point, that is the sixth point, the Great Indian Desert, that is the Thar Desert. It is also known as the Great Indian Desert. It extends from the Sutlej River in the north, then Aravali Ranges on the east, Great Run of Kunj on the south and by the Indus River on the west. These are the information of features of India, children.
Thank you for all watching the video. If you really liked our video, click on the like button, share and do subscribe. From Gnanajyoti team, alone we can do so little, together we can do so much. For further information, kindly visit our website, that is www.gnanajyoti.in.